Hi guys, and welcome to another WordPress Elementor Page Builder tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Well, in our last video, we just installed the Elementor plugin and had a little look around. So in this one, let's see how easy it is to throw a page together. So I've just got the 2011 theme, generic theme here installed. I've just installed the Elementor plugin, and here it is in our dashboard sidebar there. Let's go and add a new page. And before I add it, let's have a look. We've got a default template, and Elementor's added a couple of options here, Canvas and Elementor Full Width. Let's see what the full width, I think that's probably what I want there. So I'm going to call this test page. I'll go ahead and publish it and have a look. Yeah, I see that's got our page title there. And that's full width. So let's go back. Let's have a look if we put the default one on. Doesn't look a lot different to me. Okay. Well, let's stick with that one. Or Elementor full width. Let's go ahead and use our Elementor page builder. And that's opened up our new page here. We've got two tabs, elements and global. Here's our elements that are included. Looks like an interesting bunch of elements. And you can get more with the pro version, obviously. It's the global. Okay. You only get global ones with the pro version. Okay, and we can add things by add a section by using that, or let's have a look, see if they've got any templates in the free version. Yep, they sure do. Good grief. Oh, I see those, some of them have got the little red pro button in the top corner there. But there's still a good selection here without it, so let's just throw one of these templates in and have a look at it. Wow. Well, how quick was that? We've just thrown together a whole page. And I'm guessing the little pencil icon in all of these sections here. It's what you use to edit them. Yep, there we go. Update on a little green button down there. There we go. Simple as that. Well, it's okay. I don't know if it's going to quite work with our styling here. But the little eye icon there, we can preview our changes. We can check it on responsive tablet mobile versions there, that's handy. History, you can undo stuff there. Navigator, not sure what that is. Oh, I see, it's showing us what little sections we've got. That's quite handy. And settings. My title. Well, hide the page title. Page layout, eliminate a full width. It'll update that. Let's just preview our changes. That's quite impressive, actually. It's put a nice looking little site here. Obviously, you'll have to farm in your own images and text and what have you. But actually, that is quite impressive. Now, how can we make it work? Let's create a menu quickly and see if we can't get it to scroll to these sections here. I was planning to do the little modules. 3 little bars at the top here. I'm going to go down, exit to dashboard. I'm going to go to appearance. I'm going to create a menu quickly. Let's use some custom links with some IDs, CSS IDs, and we'll create them in a minute. See if we can't scroll to the template. So we'll call this test as well. Create menu. Custom link. First one, just a hashtag for the top of the page. I'll call it home. And next one, let's just say about. I'm doing this pretty quick. I'm just guessing. I just want to see how quickly we can throw a page together with this. Services. I'm putting hashtag up here because I'm going to create some IDs. We always use a hashtag for IDs on the sections themselves in a minute that we can jump to with this menu. And if we've got hashtag and the section ID name, that's where it will jump to. Try team. And let's do one more contact. Okay. And we'll add that to menu. We'll save this menu. And make sure we save these changes. Yeah, it looks like we did. So let's go back. I'll hit that update button. Okay, now let's go to our theme customizer. As you can see, it's 2017, and we've set our home page to that page we just created, which was test. Should appear here. There it is. Okay. Not too sure about that long piece on the top. So let's get rid of that. Header media. Hide image. That's looking more like it. Now let's add that menu that we just created. Top menu, and it was called test. There we go. Okay. Let's publish that. And exit out of this. Visit our site. Wow. So what have we got here? We've kind of got team. That'll do for an about team. We don't need all these sections, but let's link these to our sections. Home takes us to the top. About, these won't do anything at the moment because we don't actually have those IDs in place. So let's do that quickly. So we want to edit with Eliminator or Elementor. I keep calling it Eliminator for some reason. And let's give our sections a little blue tag right on the top here in the middle is obviously the section, edit section with the dots in the middle. If you want to add a section, hit that one. If you want to get rid of it, hit the X. Okay, so I've hit the three dots in the middle. I want to give it an ID so we can scroll to it with the menu. That's probably going to be under advanced. Let's have a look at the styling. Okay, different backgrounds and what have you, that's fine. CSS ID right here. We'll call this one about and save that one. I'm going through this as quickly as I can. Team, we've got a team one, so let's give this one, select the section again. Advanced CSS ID. Team. We don't have an FAQ section as such, but let's just call this one the FAQ section. The update button. Well, let's see if we can't add a services section is what we want. So let's just say we'll call this one the contact section. It's got an email address in there, that'll do. So little buttons right there, advanced contact. Save that. So we really need, I think it was a services section, wasn't it? Between the team and that section. So let's hit the plus button for add a section. And we can either hit the little grid icon here to get back to our widgets, or let's hit add template. This time, let's see if we can add just a single block. Ideal. And it was services. Have we got anything for services? Got a search box there. Let's put services. Okay, pretty cool. That one. And just hit the insert. And again, looks like there's a lot of free ones here. In fact, all of these are free. Okay, let's put in this black one here. Wow, that was easy. And again, I want to edit it and call it services, CSS ID. Remember, it's an ID, not a class ID. Okay, let's update that. And hit the little icon for preview changes. There we have it. There's our new services section. Let's see if our menu is going to scroll down to these things. So we've got home, which is at the top here, so I'm not going to put about. Yeah, that takes us there. Services. Fantastic. Team. FAQ. Not really, but it'll do. Wow. So that was pretty quick, actually, to build a little site here. Obviously, we'd want to put a... not sure if I'd want that up there. It's the sort of site name, and obviously you want a site tag that's more descriptive, or rather have your logo up there. Let's go back to the editor. And how easy is it, I wonder, to change the background color of this section? So let's click that for edit section. Let's go to style. Background, here's the background. Pretty easy. Pretty easy. Okay. Okay, we can have a gradient or we can have a video. Let's make a gradient of a bit lighter at the top there, like blue. And down the bottom, let's make it sort of dark purpley, a bit darker. Well, that's quite impressive. Yeah, that was easy to do, update. So for a free builder, that's pretty good. I'm gonna leave it there. Let's just preview our changes. And we'll do another one doing it with the Scratch modules. We'll take a look at the modules. But so far, I'm quite impressed with this little Elementor page builder. We've gone from our pretty boring looking 2011 site to something that you could actually use. Like I say, obviously you want to put your own content in here, but it's done most of the hard work for you, and it scrolls up, scrolls down. Very nice. So good. In the next video, we'll try doing this with individual widgets and see how easy it is. But I'm quite impressed with those little plugin blocks. Very good. So I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web design, then have a look below. We've got some great free courses as well as some premium courses with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. So do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.